students and people in the local area saying that Driscoll's and any farm work is a Mexican job, and it's not a Mexican job. They're just jobs for anyone who is willing to work under those conditions, and Americans are the ones that decide not to work. Even though I don't work, it affects me because I have a family and family friends that work in Driscoll's or any type of farm work.
I finished my job, señora. I finished.
Okay, here's your money.
Thank you, señora.
Hey, you want to hear a joke?
Sure.
Why can't Mexicans play Uno?
Why?
They steal all the green cards.
Ha. Duh. Want to hear another one?
Sure.
What do you call a sweating Mexican?
I don't know what.
Jalapeno.
Duh. What is a Mexican's favorite sport?
What?
Cross country.
Give me a racial stereotype that you know about Mexicans.
Enchiladas, frijoles, chetos, guacamole, pozole, menudo, elotes, chicharrones.
Look for me! I want tamales!
What about white people?
McDonald's, Burger King.
But piece by piece, he collected me up off the ground.
Hola, mi nombre es Elizabeth. Este es el canal Univisión por 180. Estoy en Fall River High School con Camarón. Hola, Camarón.
Hola.
Can I ask you some questions?
Sí.
Okay, I would like to ask you about some stereotypes that you know. Can you name a stereotype about Mexicans?
When I think about Mexicans, I think about sombreros and quesadillas.
Can I ask you a stereotype about white people?
When I think about white people, I think about pizza.
And tell me a stereotype that you think about
African Americans. When I think about
African Americans,
I think
about Colonels! Leave me alone!
As you see, racial stereotypes lead to racial jokes. That's why it's a bad idea to say racist jokes, as you end up hurting someone's feelings. You can create violence. You can also have someone fall into a deep depression, and they can commit suicide. So let's please stop with these racist jokes, as you know that...
Adios mío!
Yo también con los dedos que se me hinchan y el dinero que nos pagan.
Y los americanos nos valoran.
Ay, yo también tengo los dedos bien hinchados, ya ni los aguanto.
Duelen mucho.
Sí,
demasiado.
This is America, we speak English.
This is a free country.
No, it ain't.
Many have told us, this is America, speak English. But many are surprised to know that the United States has no official language. That's why it's a great advantage to know more than two languages in the United States. It's a great advantage because you have a better opportunity in getting jobs than other people. You also have opportunity to meet more people, and you could also travel to other countries. That's why it's a great advantage to speak more than two languages.
Can I take your order?
Yes. Me da dos big cheeseburgers. No sangre porque. No. Nah.
No bueno.
Nah. No bueno. No good. No good.
Dos refrescos.
Big.
De Coca-Cola.
Dieta, por favor.
No sé.
¿Qué es esto?
money.
Mom. Oh, you got a problem?
Sí. ¿No qué es esto?
We said...
Ariana, Ariana Grande! B!
No, 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 sorry, no hablamos inglés.
Ay, perdón.
¿Tenemos uno grande?
Lo tiene chiquito. No sé por qué no tienen gente bilingüe, si saben que tienen mucho paisita aquí a comer o lo que sea, pero no sé.
¿Fretitos aquí?
No, fretitos. Perdónanos. ¿Fretitos como el frijol?
Perdón. Oh, yo las atiendo a ustedes con mucho gusto.
Gracias, gracias, gracias.
Abby, you can please get the person on the phone. And I'll take their order.
A ver, hola, dígame, ¿qué quieren?
Absolutely. A lot of the times it's just the lack of knowledge. Some people need to be educated and also need to be exposed to different cultures and to different people. So a lot of the times I just feel it's the lack of knowledge, the lack of knowing or being exposed to other cultures. So definitely it can be solved. Some people just need to be educated about it.
That's a tough question. I mean, ultimately, I would wish that racism could be solved, but I think the only way that we're going to be able to solve racism is for people that tend to be in the race that considers itself superior to be able to realize the privileges that they have and decide that they want to start to share those privileges with all peoples. And until that happens, and people are ready to give up their fear and anger, it's probably not going to be solved.
I think racism can be solved. It's going to take a lot of understanding and people opening their minds to different views. A lot of racism, I think, stems from fear of the unknown. So if we could just be more open with each other, we would realize we're a lot more similar than we think.
If there was no racism or discrimination around the world, definitely we will have a better world, because I believe in this quote that says, it is in our differences where we find our unity. So basically, if there was no racism and people will be willing to get to know other cultures and treat everybody equally, definitely we will have a more peaceful world.
I would like to think that if there were no racism, that would be a wonderful, happy, peaceful world. And I'm sure that those things could happen. However, I feel like human nature would probably find something new to attack about peoples.
If there were no racism, it'd be a much more peaceful world. A lot of the conflict in the world comes from racism and misunderstanding of other cultures.
So first of all, you know, throughout my college career and also my jobs, different jobs that I had as an undergrad student, I have faced discrimination and people being racist to me. But basically what I do, instead of responding in a negative way, I kind of like get back to people with kindness, like being kind and not being afraid to say what I want to say, how I feel about my ethnicity, instead of showing them like how proud I feel about it, regardless of what they think about me. So basically, I'm just nice to people.
If someone were racist towards me, I guess that I'm actually pretty lucky, because I tend to come from the race where people aren't very racist against me, which is a sad state of the world. I tend to live in a world of white privilege. So it would actually be pretty difficult for me to understand what it would be like if somebody were racist towards me.
I can't imagine it would feel very good. I'm fortunate enough I haven't had to experience that. But to be judged based on something that is so insignificant and not something all involving your character is unfortunate and a sad fact of our current reality.
If I ever witness racism, I actually wouldn't ignore it. I will approach the two different people, the one trying to discriminate the other person and the victim, and I will probably have a conversation with both of them. But of course, it will depend on the situation and also how much of anger is between those two people. So definitely, I will do something about it, and it will depend on the situation.
If you witness racism, probably the first thing that you should do is to actually try to put a stop to it immediately when you see it. So when you hear that horrible racist joke, it's probably best, instead of just laughing or trying to ignore it, to actually stand up and try to perhaps teach the people who are saying it what's so awful about it.
You gotta stand up. You can't just let it go by. That you're not, the fact that you're not participating in the racism doesn't make it okay to just sit there and watch it. You've gotta stand up and say something and not allow it to happen, even if it's not happening to you.
Cause I've still got a lot of fire left in me.
We should be like a proton and electron. They're both particles that have a different charge that attract together. Therefore, we are all humans with a different race that should come together to make everything better.